In this lesson, we will discuss the translation and linear strain of fluid elements. Here we have a velocity field that varies in time and space. If we place a fluid element of size dx, dy, dz into this velocity field, the fluid element will move and deform. We can separate the overall motion of the fluid element into four types of motion: translation, linear strain, also called dilatation, solid body rotation, and shear strain. Translation is movement without strain or rotation. It occurs if there are no local velocity gradients. At time t, we have a fluid element with sides dx, dy, and dz. Since we are looking at the side of a fluid element, the fluid element extends a distance dz into the screen. The components of the velocity field, lowercase u and lowercase v, are the same along the entire perimeter of the fluid element. A small time dt passes and the fluid element moves to a new location. Since distance equals rate times time, the fluid element has traveled a distance u times dt in the x direction and a distance v times dt in the y direction. Linear strain of a fluid element occurs if there are velocity gradients in the direction of motion, that is, if partial u partial x, partial v partial y, and/or partial w partial z are non-zero. Here is a fluid element at time t, with sides of length dx, dy, and dz, with dz extending into the screen. The initial volume of the fluid element is v-naught, and the area to the right and left sides of the fluid element are dy times dz. The left side of the fluid element is at a position x0, and the right side of the fluid element is located at a position x0 plus dx. Let's assume there's a local velocity gradient of the x component of the velocity in the x direction only, and there are no other local velocity gradients. On the left side of the fluid element, we label the velocity component in the x direction as u x0. On the right side of the fluid element, we label the velocity component in the x direction as u x0 plus dx. Assuming dx is very small, we can use a Taylor series approximation to relate the velocity on the right side to the velocity on the left side. U at x0 plus dx is approximately equal to u at x0 plus partial u partial x times dx. Partial u partial x is evaluated at x0 as well, but we will leave off the x0 to avoid cluttering the screen. After some very small time dt passes, the fluid element translates and undergoes linear strain in the x direction, since the velocity on the left side and right side of the fluid element are different. In order to more easily analyze the fluid element, the amount of translation and strain that occurs during time dt are exaggerated for clarity. In reality, the fluid element will appear to change imperceptibly during the small time dt. Since the difference in the velocity between the right and left sides is partial u partial x dx, the fluid element will have changed its length in the x direction by partial u partial x dx times dt. Comparing the new volume of the fluid element to the original volume v0, which is shown here with blue dashed lines, the volume will have increased by an amount dv. Linear strain is defined as the fractional increase in length of a side of the fluid element. So we take the change in length, partial u partial x dx dt, and divide by the original length dx. The dx's cancel out and we are left with partial u partial x times dt. In fluid mechanics, the rate of linear strain is more useful since fluid elements can deform continuously. If we divide the linear strain that occurs during time dt by the time dt, we obtain the linear strain rate in the x direction, which will be denoted as epsilon xx. The dt's cancel out and we are left with partial u partial x as a linear strain rate in the x direction. We also can relate the linear strain rate to the time rate of change of the fluid element's volume. The change in volume of the fluid element during time dt due to linear strain in the x direction is dv. dv is the length, partial u partial x dx dt, multiplied by the area dy dz. We collect the terms dx, dy, dz and notice that they are equal to the original volume, V naught. We now divide both sides of the equation by V naught times dt and obtain dv dt divided by V naught equals partial u, partial x. This means the time rate of change of volume per unit volume is equal to the velocity gradient partial u, partial x. This velocity gradient is also equal to the linear strain rate in the x direction. If we perform the same analysis in the y and z directions, we would find that the linear strain rate in the y direction, epsilon yy, is equal to partial v partial y, and the linear strain rate in the z direction, epsilon zz, is equal to partial w partial z. It is possible to have velocity gradients in all three directions simultaneously. As we have just discussed, the velocity gradients can be related to the time rate of change of the fluid element's volume. Therefore, the volumetric dilation rate, or total rate of change in a fluid element's volume, is the sum of the linear strain rates in all three directions. Epsilon xx plus epsilon yy plus epsilon zz is equal to partial u partial x plus partial v partial y plus partial w partial z. This expression is also equal to the divergence of the velocity field. A common special case in fluid dynamics is incompressible flow, in which the fluid density can be approximated as constant. Density is the ratio of a fluid's mass to its volume, and since we are examining a fluid element of fixed mass, this means the volume must be constant as well in an incompressible flow. Here we have a fluid element with initial volume V0 in an incompressible flow. If the fluid element expands in one direction, it must undergo a contraction in another direction in order to keep the volume of the fluid element constant. Mathematically, since there is no change in volume, the dilation rate is zero, which means the divergence of the velocity field is zero as well. In other words, a fluid element will not experience a net expansion or contraction in an incompressible flow. We will obtain the same result when examining the differential form of the conservation of mass equation in a future video.